sign in on our JHA, and they'll join us.
Okay. So far, so good? Mm-hmm. Anything y'all have questions about yet before we get started on this? Okay. Here's where you get the next ladder. You know the universal mount that you had this morning? You were able to put it anywhere you wanted to. It was tracked. This ladder is not that way. You only can connect at these connection points. The way this connection point works, there's a block that has to be lifted to let this thing twist. You can also use the knob that's located on the back to release the lift. It's on a piece of metal, like a bolt. If I pick it up like this, it binds and will not lift. So I have to grab the whole handle and lift it up. Okay? So don't get all macho with it because it's not as easy. It's a lot easier if you just go back there and gently lift it up. Once it's lifted, then this turns or pivots on that single pivot point. This doesn't move, none of this stuff moves, just this track. And then it's in position to accept this. Put this on. Yellow away from you, arrow away, so when you lift it up, the arrow is always pointing up. The arrow will point up when you're climbing up, and the arrow points up when you're climbing down, so it's always pointing up. You know that is true, you know you got a position, the little black dot is on top too. So I always suggest that when you pick this thing up, put your fingers under this, because you need to scan that screen, and put your thumb on the little black dot. When you do, you get a pinch, and it slides on really nicely. Okay? If it's not pinched, the spring pulls that down. It doesn't move very easily. Pinch it, moves easily. So I get that thing on. Once it's on, I turn the track. Once I turn the track back in line, this thing lifts straight up. Okay? So again, arrow pointing up, dots on the top. So you're climbing, you're climbing, you're climbing, yada, yada, yada. You get up to that deck, you're going to lift up the hatch to the right, all of them open to the right. So you'll probably be hanging on with your left hand and pushing with your right hand. Once you get that thing lifted, then I suggest you can climb all the way through. You know, all the way through up to the little above the deck, so that you can very easily then lower yourself down onto the deck. You see, it'd be a lot more difficult to try to put your foot up there and pick yourself up from the side. Okay, so it's easier to climb through and step off. Once you're off, you need to get tied up. Attached to the rail. I told you that this morning we're going to let the handrails. Or I can go to this engineered anchor point. Contrasting color, it's pink. That's because we have yellow lights. Everything looks kind of yellow in here. So we can attach to each of these connection points. And once we do, then we've got to take this off. So I'm taking this off. Getting that about in the middle. Bringing this up. Moving to the side. Sliding it off. Bring it back. I get off the hatch and I tell somebody, there, which means they can now start climbing. From the time I go through the hatch, step off, close the hatch. Once the hatch is closed, the guy down here can go get it set up, ready to climb. Waiting. Once everything is clear, does not need tension. Yeah, it's just nice and heavy, and it'll slide up and down easily. Where this is cut, you know, for joints, sometimes it gets stuck. If that's the case, just reach up, pinch it, and push it down, and the weight of it should continue to push it down. If you were to fall, the very first thing that happens is this loses tension, that's spring-loaded, so it locks onto the rail. As soon as it locks onto the rail, you have this far to fall. Remember, on the start of D-ring, you have up to a 2 foot free fall for limited fall arrest. So this is limited fall arrest under a 2 foot free fall, and it has a lanyard for that tear webbing. So you got some tear webbing in here to absorb the energy of the fall if that were to happen. Okay? Lad Safe and the Glide Lock do not have this, but they also have a really, really short connector. Okay? So their connector is within 6 inches, so they don't have to have the extra lanyard. Okay? Okay. Alright. If you're climbing and you get a little bit fatigued, if you want to take a moment, push that up. It naturally pulls this down, which locks it. Whatever you need to do, take your time. Once you feel like you're ready to climb again, if you are, then you'll just start your climb. Once you climb past this, it will naturally just start to go with you. how we're going to do it all the way up, we're just going to go deck by deck, so it'll make it extremely easy for you, okay? But like I said before, do, I guess the word is pace yourself. I don't really like that word, but that's probably the best. This is a 30-foot section, obviously not very far. The next one is 70 feet. The one after that is 70 feet. The one after that is 30 feet. The one after that is 40. So you have some distance to go. You know, you don't want to just part it up in the first few feet. We've had people that, after the first section, they said, oh man, I'm not going to be able to do this. So their choice is to see how far they can climb before they fail, you know, before their body gives up, or just get in the lift and ride it to the top, and then climb the last 40 feet to get into the cell and see what it looks like. And in some cases, they've opted to go ahead and take the ride. You don't get the certificate for climb, but at least you get to see what's up there. And other people have climbed to exhaustion, and we help them down with a rope, and they don't ever see what's up there. Either way, they don't get the certificate, but it's just kind of a decision that they have to make. I think this crew's going to make it just fine.
You
know, if not, we can put you in the lift. Any last questions? I'll take the first leg. I do that so that you don't have to watch me huffing and puffing like a old man. Okay? And you'll see the little stripes on them. You can click a hard hat light on so you can see them clearly if you want to. But that's the kind of work that will be done on a regular basis, like annual, semi-annual. And that's what they'll be starting tomorrow morning. Retorquing and everything else. But that's part of what they're coming out to do, okay? So there's a lot of tasks to do, but that's one of those tasks. So as you go to work in the industry, this may be something that you're asked to do, you know, provided that you're qualified to do that, okay? So it's an important thing.
This is high torque?
That's what you use the high torque machine to use. There's a lot of different competitive brands. High torque seems to be the most recognized name.
County man.
Okay. Everybody's good? Okay. Nobody's passed that on or anything?
Right. No, that's a brain name.
Like Grizzly. Grizzly's a brain name.
It's not a dog.
Remember, you got another 70 after this one.
He was
following? Hey, what?